Mr. Secretary, my question is related to seniors who receive services at home. We're seeing more and more that seniors are preferring to age in place and given the potential savings to the Commonwealth associated with providing supports in home to our seniors, as opposed to seniors going to nursing care facilities. Can you explain why the administration chose not to include an initiative to reduce the options waiting list?
Yeah. Well, at this time, again, with the infusion of federal dollars that we have, the area agencies on aging have sufficient funding to address some of these needs. Our list, the options waiting list, has decreased. But just to give you an example of what I just finished saying in terms of the direct care worker, the amount of individuals waiting because a provider is not available has increased. Last year, there was about 814 individuals that were waiting as a result of a provider not being available. This year is up to 1,675, so more than double. The list has grown. It's reduced the other way, waiting because of funding of services. But again, direct care workers seems to be the biggest challenge right now in terms of providing. Now with the option services, care management, which is assessing the needs of older adults, that's always given. If there's an older adult that needs food, that's a top priority. So we have individuals that are receiving those services but are waiting, again, for a provider or some other services to be made available.
Right. Well, thank you for that. You also just mentioned about, I think, the influx of federal dollars. But in your opinion, how much would it cost if we were to eliminate the waiting list in of itself?
Well, I guess two budgets ago, we were requesting about $8 million to tackle that list. It's a difficult, but I don't think that would have addressed the list itself, because I don't believe that list will ever be eliminated, because once you provide all the services, right now we're at 25% of our population, 3.4 million over the age of 60, and that's just going to continue to grow. So as people continue to age, those needs are going to increase as well.
So as we talk about the needs increasing, and again, I recognize that Pennsylvania has an older population, and that's a continuum. In your opinion, cost savings for folks who are receiving supports in home versus folks who are going to nursing care facilities, are we seeing basically, and again, I'm not talking about the influx of federal dollars, but are we getting a sense, maybe it might be pre-pandemic or something of that nature, but is there a sense that by folks being at home, that we actually are saving taxpayers' dollars here because we're spending, and I don't want to say we're spending less, but I believe that there is a less expense for folks to be at home versus being in a nursing facility.
Yeah, there's no question if you have someone at a skilled nursing facility, that's going to be a very expensive option. So doing what we can to provide home and community-based services that will keep them safe and healthy in their home, it's a lower cost option if you're looking at finances. Our department, we oversee what are called domiciliary care homes, and those are homes that have less than 3 beds, and they're in the community, and that's one way that we try to support older adults. The problem is those homes have been decreasing, as well as personal care homes. So the governor proposed $50 million personal care home supplement, and that's a proposal that I believe is important, because again, we've been seeing personal care homes close since 2015. We've had 408 close, and that's the equivalent of about, I believe, 1,700 beds that are not available for older adults. So that's an issue that we need to work on in terms of making sure that we have some viable options for older adults so that we can keep them out of skilled nursing facilities that are going to be much more expensive option in the long run.
I appreciate that answer. Let me just go back. I just want to be clear with what I just thought I heard you say. I know you mentioned roughly 1,700 beds, but how many personal care homes have we seen close? Did you say 500 plus?
410 since 2015.
410. Great. Listen, I appreciate you being here. We all heard the governor share with us his proposed budget. I do have to say this, that I represent the city of Philadelphia, and in my district there are personal care homes, and I'd like to think, in fact, I know for a fact, it's not about me thinking, but I know for a fact that these personal care homes have provided supports to individuals who would otherwise be in another facility, costing us much more money. So I'm glad to see that the governor did propose to increase the cost for those providers of personal care homes. Thank you very much, Mr. Secretary.
Thank you, Mr. Representative. Chair.